Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Anjanita Octaviani. Now I would like to present my proposal with the title The Use of Zoom Cloud Meeting for Teaching English Grammar in an Online Class. I will start from the first one about fundamental and theoretical framework. Nowadays, online teaching and learning process become current issues around the world because of COVID-19. While teaching online, it should be supported by online platforms. There are a lot of online platforms such as Google Classroom, Google Hangout, eLearning, WhatsApp, Telegram, YouTube, Instagram, Google Meet, Microsoft Teams, Zoom Cloud Meeting, Skype, GoToMeeting, and Cisco WebEx Teams. And currently, the most popular online platform that has many users for virtual meeting in many countries is Zoom Cloud Meeting. For the next are relevant previous studies related to my topic. There are some previous studies that show their research about the use of Zoom on the sociology, anthropology, statistics, and physics course are very effective. The second, other previous studies found that the students perceive the positive perception, satisfaction, and response about the use of technology in this pandemic situation. And last, the other studies are conducted to investigate about an online learning which the subject were university students from China and Malaysia. Based on the previous studies that I mentioned before, I conclude the gaps that the first, there are few research about the use of Zoom Cloud Meeting, including the implementation, strengths, and weaknesses for English language teaching in Indonesian context. The second, most previous studies about the use of online media focused on student perception than teacher perception. And last, there are many studies which are conducted in the university level. Thus, from all those gaps that I found, I plan to combine all gaps become gaps on my research. Here, I write three research questions based on the gaps. Therefore, I provide this research question number one. How does the implementation of using Zoom Cloud Meeting for teaching English grammar in an online class? The second, what are teachers' obstacles of using Zoom Cloud Meeting for teaching English grammar in an online class? And the last, what are teachers' perceptions about the use of Zoom Cloud Meeting for teaching English grammar in an online class? Okay, next is definition of key terms. I elaborate the definition of key terms to give background knowledge about this study. So based on the topic of this study, there are five key terms, which are Zoom Cloud Meeting, teaching grammar, online class, teacher obstacle, and teacher perception. So Zoom Cloud Meeting, defined as web-based conferencing which provide contents such as video and audio recording, screen sharing, group chatting for online teaching. And teaching grammar is the practice of teaching theory of English grammar or structure in the senior high school, because the study focused on senior high school. And for online class is a teaching and learning environment by interacting between teacher and students via computer based and internet. And for teacher perception is an opinion of the teacher that can be positive or negative thoughts, ideas, and feelings about teaching English by using technology, especially Zoom. And the last teacher obstacle is a problem that faced by the teacher in the teaching and learning process by using Zoom. Move to the research design. This study uses a qualitative research design, which is descriptive research. I use this method to investigate the implementation, teachers' obstacles, and teacher perception about the use of Zoom for English language teaching. Therefore, this research doesn't manipulate because it is explained by natural language and it is appropriate to answer all of three research questions. For the participants of the studies are English teachers of senior high school because some previous studies conducted the study about Zoom in the university levels. Therefore, I want to investigate the use of Zoom in the senior high school. And for the setting, I choose SMA N1 Trio Regio Gresik as the location to conduct this research. The first reason, because this school is still doing online learning fully, even though some schools try to do blended or hybrid learning, so that the teachers obtainably use online platforms. Another reason, because when I was doing PLP in this school, I saw that only few teachers who use Zoom. Most of teachers prefer to use Google Classroom than Zoom. Thus, I want to investigate the perception and also the obstacle from the teachers. The next point is research instruments. I applied two instruments, including observation checklist and interview guideline. For observation checklist, will be used while observing the situation on the class. The information will be gained from the steps of teaching English by using Zoom. And I will give a checklist in the column of observation sheet whether the process is going well or not. It can answer the first research questions. While interview guideline, it provides a list of questions for interview before the interview session to make it organized well. Thus, when interview is conducted, I will be easy to ask by looking at the guideline, and it can answer the second and third research questions. For data collection method, I use observation and interview because they are suitable for qualitative research. For the observation, I prefer participant observation because I will involve with the teacher and interact directly in the teaching process to investigate the implementation of teaching English grammar by using Zoom. I will also use a video recording in the Zoom as the data of observation. I also give checklists in the observation sheet based on the situation in the class. So this method can answer such question number one. And for the interview, I use semi-structured interview because although I prepare a list of questions, I will also add some questions related to the topic and teacher answer about the obstacle and perception while using Zoom. I will also record the conversation between us by using audio recording on mobile phone. I will connect it virtually because of this pandemic situation by calling them via WhatsApp or perhaps voice notes. So this method can answer research question number 2 and 3. To analyze the data, I follow ARI at all steps, which are familiarizing and organizing, coding and reducing, interpreting and representing. To analyze the interview data, the first stage are familiarizing and organizing. I will be familiar with the data by transcribing the data from recording to typewritten, and I will transcribe the result of the interview that I get from audio recording. I will change the teacher's utterance to be description. After that, I will organize it by giving name the file based on the topic about teacher obstacle and teacher perception. And the next stage are coding and reducing. I will give a code by using color or highlighting. For example, I will give blue color for teacher perception and yellow color for teacher obstacle. After coding, I will reduce some information which is not appropriate that I asked to minimize the data. And I will take the data which is important based on the question that I asked. And the last stage are interpreting and representing. I will interpret the data by describing the significant information with the real answer from teacher answer on the interview. And I will describe the result of the data in easy way, not in a long explanation. Then I will represent it by reporting the data in the form of description by using words, phrase, and sentence, and also table if it is necessary to support the significant information. And all of these steps to answer the research question number 2 and 3 from the interview. From the observation, to answer research question number 1, the data will analyze it only by interpreting and representing. I will describe the result of information in the observation sheet, and then I represent it in the form of description. What happened in the class and how teacher implement Zoom platform for teaching English, whether they use all of Zoom features or not. The last are references. Here are some references that I used in my proposal. Okay, that's all my presentation. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.